Hey everyone, thanks for stopping by. Today, we're diving into a topic that's really close to my heart, finding strength and holding on to faith when life gets tough. We're talking about those moments when it feels like we're carrying the weight of the world on our shoulders. We'll find our grounding with a little inspiration from Psalm 77:14, which says, "Thou art the God that doest wonders. Thou hast declared thy strength among the people." Let's be real, we all go through tough times. Sometimes it feels like you're drowning in your sorrows, and doubt just keeps piling on. You start feeling sorry for yourself, questioning your own strength, and it's easy to slip into that victim mentality. By the end of the day, you're absolutely drained. It can feel like God isn't responding to your cries for help, and yet you're still holding on. Why is that? Maybe it's what our parents taught us about faith and perseverance. So, why do we cling to that faith? A lot of it has to do with the lessons we learned growing up. Our families instilled in us the importance of faith. They taught us to cry out to the Lord when we're in need. Despite the pain, finding joy in your family can be incredibly healing. Are you willing to endure some of that pain to keep your family together? Can you accept the challenges and still see the beauty in being with loved ones? This takes us to a deeper concept, the atonement of Jesus Christ and the true meaning of sacrifice. It's about learning how to apply these principles to our lives. It's not just suffering for suffering's sake. It's about understanding that this sacrifice can lead to personal growth and deeper meaning. Sometimes life's troubles feel like a raging storm, like black clouds and terrifying lightning all around you. But here's the thing, God will deliver us from the tempest. Even when we can't see him, he's there, caring for us. By relying on the belief that God cares, we can become stronger in our trials. This is how we prevail over adversity. By facing these challenges, our perception and endurance improve. We learn things through these experiences that we'll never get from a classroom or book. These trials actually help to refine us, making us more capable of taking on hard things in life. Now, it's essential to remember, God never intended for us to spend our entire lives suffering. We are meant to us. Ether 12:16-18 talks about the power of faith. "And neither at any time hath any wrought miracles until after their faith, wherefore they first believed in the Son of God." Miracles are real, and they happen when we have faith. This was true before Christ, and it remains true today. So how do we get to participate in these miracles? It starts with choice. We have to exercise our free agency and choose to open ourselves to receive them. This might mean cleaning ourselves up, both physically and spiritually. Sometimes we need to remove doubt and create an environment where the Holy Spirit can work freely. At the center of all this is our relationship with Jesus Christ. Everything we do should focus on strengthening that bond. We don't control the outcomes. Those are in God's hands. We are just instruments of faith. It's the Lord who saves souls, not us. We're not responsible for carrying that weight. So, to wrap things up, yes, life is tough and filled with trials, but through faith and a strong relationship with God, we can find joy and be open to miracles. Jesus loves us and will heal us if we believe. Miracles haven't ceased, and God is dependable. Hold tight to your faith and trust that He won't abandon us in our trials. Thank you so much for watching. If this message resonated with you, be sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe for more uplifting content. See you next time.